curb appeal. There's one part of houses and buildings that are totally overlooked. I'm talking about that half pipe hanging on the edge of our roofs. Yep, gutters. They're so simple, and yet they catch all the rain like a champ. But most of that rain just goes down the drain. It turns out that the greenest way to deal with all that water might be to tuck it in a big underground bucket. Here's Alie Ward to explain.
In the heart of Los Angeles, California, there is a hilltop sanctuary that pops with green, despite Southern California's semi-arid climate. Founded in 1973 by Andy Lipkis, this plot of land wasn't always so verdant. Andy spearheaded a plan to grow this space into a hidden gem of nature, trails, and learning, and he called it TreePeople. Beneath the surface here, TreePeople has another hidden gem, which nourishes all of this land. It is a 218,000-gallon rainwater cistern.
A cistern. That's just another name for tank. And so it's a rain tank that stores rainwater that falls mostly on your roof. You collect it in your rain gutters and send it to the tank. And then you have stored water, water you can use right away for irrigating your gardens, growing your trees, keeping your landscape alive.
Built in 2002, it's made of concrete and has a diameter of 100 feet. And while cisterns have been around for centuries, it's Andy's application of rainwater cisterns to the problem of recurring water shortages in Los Angeles that's so innovative. I met up with Andy to talk about the benefits of rainwater cisterns in everyday life and in emergencies.
In designing this, did you have any inspiration from nature at all?
Yes, we biomimicked, copied the engineering model of an oak tree. And that's exactly what this is. An oak tree that's got a canopy that's 100 feet in diameter, like this.
Andy explained how the analogy continues. The root system of a tree captures water, just like a sponge or a tank. But Andy's goals extend beyond harvesting rainwater in cisterns to what that water can grow, trees. Trees themselves provide important canopy and cooling for communities in hot climates.
When you look out and you're looking at the city and the trees kind of juxtaposed, is that pretty much what your life's work is trying to figure out how to incorporate more trees in a city?
So one of our next goals is to create a protective tree canopy cover over communities across Los Angeles, done with them, to protect them from the new severe heat.
In Los Angeles, the current system of runoff sends rainwater downhill along with pollutants it picks up. All of that filters into the Los Angeles River and then flows straight into the ocean. Instead, Andy wants to capture every drop of scarce rainfall in cisterns and use it for land irrigation, community building, and to create a better home for all of us.
They say big trees, little acorns. It all starts somewhere.
It does. And, you know, I just have to stretch that to say the tallest tree in the world is the California Coast Redwood, and it comes from one of the smallest seeds in the world. When it sprouts, it's nearly microscopic. And that, to me, represents our dream.